Everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for another Soulookie Silly's here on the channel. Today, I'm going to be returning as Vala on the Tomb of the Spider Queen, and on our team today, we have got ourselves Leoric, Zagara, Chen, Vala, Nazebo taking on Leoric, Johanna, Sergeant Hammer, Nazebo, and Illidan. Vala is my, well, she used to be my main go-to ranged assassin until Kael'thas came along. Vala has quickly slipped to the number two, possibly even third position. I've got to be honest, I've been playing a lot of Jaina. Jaina is someone who has steadily crept up into the ranks of the top tier of ranged assassins along with Kael'thas. I know that everyone is expecting me to say Sylvanas, and yeah, I do consider Sylvanas as a ranged assassin. Look, Blizzard has already said that they're going to be reevaluating some roles for some heroes, and I have a feeling you're going to see good old Sylvanas move to an assassin and good old Tyrone. Tyrande, she's going to be moved to a specialist. It's just a hunch. Just a hunch. I'm not trying to say that I've got any sort of insider knowledge on the comings and goings of Blizzard Entertainment. I'm just saying that I've been playing this game for a little while now. Can use Vault to break away from Drain Hope. And King Leoric would be wise not to trade with Vala. Not, at least not right now, anyway. Because I definitely will make an Act 1 boss fight out of him. Diablo 3 joke. I'm really looking forward to the new Diablo patch, man. I don't even care what anyone says. The fact that they're adding a sort of, kind of, Herodric Cube-esque item in the game is more than enough for me to be excited again. Again, I want to use Vault to get away from the Drain Hope of Leoric. It greatly stunts the amount of survivability that Leoric has, and it also makes him waste a lot of mana. We're just going to walk away from Leoric. We'll go ahead and tap the fountain as well. But Vala is steadily, she's been declining as of late, which is a little bit sad just because of the simple fact that I really like how she plays. Vala was the first ranged assassin that I've ever played. That I truly and honestly have liked. Kael'thas, and I'm glad that a lot of my fans were kind of paying attention to the comment that I made, which was that I feel that no other hero since the game has been released has ever changed the meta as hard as Kael'thas has. Kael'thas, when he dropped onto the scene, it was a big time deal, and I think that he still is the most impactful hero. Some people would probably speculate that maybe Sylvanas would be kind of up there as well, as far as having a huge impact on the current state of the game, but I still feel that Kael'thas, with the way that he was released and how much of an immediate impact he was, because he is so simple to play but hard to master sort of thing, as comparing to Sylvanas, who is kind of difficult to play if you're not used to playing the specialist role. I would still argue that I believe that Kael'thas had more of an impact than any other hero that's been released in the game thus far. Sylvanas is definitely number two, don't get me wrong. She is not it's not a far off on number two either. But she certainly did have a pretty big impact on the game. But I still feel that Kael'thas is it. So level 4, by the way, I'm going to take Manticore, this is going to be my right-click build, this is my standard build that I do for Vala. You'll see a lot of better, not really, I don't want to call them better, but you'll see other, I guess, higher level Vala players not do this build. They usually go for the multi-shot build with grenades and all that kind of good stuff, which is fine. I'm not a huge fan of that build, to be quite honest. We should be able to get a kill on the Z-Bro here, we might even get a kill on Johanna if she's not careful. But I'm not a big fan of the multi-shot build because it's very mana intensive, and I feel like honestly Vala's strengths lies with her auto attack, and the fact that Manticore does triple damage when it hits the same target over and over again is pretty darn good. That's Manticore right there. Not triple damage, sorry. It's 50% additional damage on the third attack. Triple damage would be a little bit broken. All right, Uncle Chan. I've got middle wrapped up. Crazy Uncle Chan. We're good. I'm not tapping the fountain on purpose because right now I don't really have a whole lot of mana to spend. And yeah, just gonna be poking with Hungering Arrow. Hungering Arrow does an amazing amount of damage. Also, it has an incredible range. That's something that a lot of people really don't think about. Hungering Arrow's range is quite ridiculous sometimes. Oh, nice wall there by Nazebo. And I again don't really care about. I don't really care about Johanna or Leoric, to be quite honest. You have Nazebo coming in from the top lane. Again, not really worried about him either. As long as I have enough mana for Vault, I am good to go, man. Level 7, super duper easy. Always go for Searing Attacks. Searing Attacks is going to basically give me guaranteed crits for on my basic attacks for the duration of, I think it's like 5 seconds. Yeah, something like that. 5 seconds. It does cost a little bit of mana every basic attack, but it's worth it. As I'll show you right now as I go ham on, on the Orc and then go ham on Johanna. And somehow the enemy team was able to get the turn in, even though we have had control. I guess we haven't really had control of bottom lane. There we go, just gonna keep on farming in mid. I did see Illidan briefly sneak down here. I'm not sure exactly where he's gonna go. There they are. I'm not sure if you caught that there. I was trying to take Illidan next to the turrets whenever he was gonna use his dive on me, and unfortunately did not quite get him there. That is not a good spot for you, Illidan. That is definitely not a good spot. I'm gonna activate Searing Attacks here. I am unfortunately out of mana, which means the Searing Attacks will fall off a little bit sooner than I would like. And I got clipped by the Webweaver twice. That's two times I took damage from the Webweaver. The first time definitely should not have happened. That time, it was me trying to get away from the Orc, and I got slowed by the Skeletal Strike. So, definitely a misplay there. But the Webweavers weren't able to do much. Uncle Chen was able to get the majority of the gems that I dropped. Definitely a death that should not have happened. It's more of a case of me not really paying attention. We definitely don't need three people in the mid, so I'm going to go rotate up the top lane and keep on soaking. I'm surprised that we gave up that cap so easily. The bottom line hasn't really seemed like they've been getting dominated. I mean, they've got a decent comp up there. I don't know what Nazebro's thinking, but this is not a good spot for you, buddy. Not a good look for you, Nazebro. Apparently we need two gems to turn in, so I'm going to turn in three. Because I always do a little bit extra in my effort. Just for the team. That's the kind of team player you can expect when you see me in your quick matches. Always giving one extra. Keeping an eye on Illidan right now in the bot lane. I want to know when he actually comes up. I see Johanna is also making attempt to motion this way. And I am going to go for Reign of Vengeance, level 10. Reign of Vengeance is just too good not to have. And if I'm able to land the combo here on Illidan, he will definitely go down easy peasy. There you go. There's the Reign of Vengeance. He's forced to use Metamorphosis just to get away. And we have taken over the bottom lane here. We should get at least two turrets. Maybe the gate, maybe. I'm just out of range from Sergeant Hammer's auto attack, by the way. Thank you, camera, for almost killing me there. I don't know whose entomb that was. Was that the enemy team's Leoric? Was that ours? That was our... Our Leoric took entomb. Alright, well. I guess he's trying out that other heroic. Look, I had decent success with Entomb, I really did, but I think it's, in my opinion, there's a pretty clear favorite as far as which heroic is better than the other for Leoric's skill set. And I did activate Searing Attacks there and tore up Illidan. He basically gets no profit from his first aid. You know, I don't like turning in only six gems, but we'll see if we can get Leoric to use Drain Hope. Or apparently I won't be able to get away from him. I thought that vault was going to take me out of range of Johanna's Condemn, but apparently not. Did she add range to the Condemn? She did not. I don't really see Johanna all that often anymore, so I'm never really... she, out of all the new heroes, she's definitely the one that I least like. I'm also the one that I've least played against. Falling Sword is going to be used on top of Nazebro. I do have Reign of Vengeance back up, and right now, with the way that the Illidan and Johanna are currently situated, I'd be able to easily stun them all. I just got to get down there. And The enemy team gets the web weaver turn in. I'm holding off on using Reign of Vengeance right now just because our team is not ready. So let's see if, oh wow, Skeleton King actually did go for it. That was a big old goof right there. A big old goof. I'm gonna back on out of there as I did see the napalm strike coming down from Sergeant Hammer. Johanna actually kind of dove there to get after me, and she is gonna pay the price for it. Hopefully, maybe, just kidding, never mind. Don't get hit by that wave again, all right. Unfortunately, I do not have a way to heal myself back up, and I would die to Illidan. So I am going to back up, unfortunately. I'm going to go Giant Killer. Giant Killer is pretty much standard for any auto-attack build. And the enemy team completely dominating the bot lane. Which has been the problem lane for this entire game. Honestly, the lane of Leoric and Sergeant Hammer, I feel like they really shouldn't be able to push that hard. Yes, Leoric. We are here. You're a king, you should act like one, Leoric. Webweavers, they were able to take down one fort, which is unfortunate. Which is one fortunate. Just making sure that the enemy team was not in the smoke. We should definitely take down our night camp while we can. So Nazebo's going to get killed by Illidan. And we have got to get somebody up there to stop that fort from going down as well. I got 5 gems, but no safe place to actually turn them in here. I'm not sure if Illidan realizes that evasion doesn't stop Hungering Arrow. Unfortunately, I was not able to save the second fort. We were able to get the Web Weaver juggle. And I'm going to quickly try to turn down the aggression on the top lane here. Now, we can't really push right now, Nazebo. I heard the Maw go off somewhere, but whether or not that actually got somebody, I don't know. I am going to use Searing Attacks right now to go right after Nazebo. And I'm trying to get away from Illidan, who's all over me. No one going after Illidan. Everyone going after Johanna, which is not who you want to go for. And that is right there what happens when everyone focuses on the wrong target. Nazebo or Illidan needs to be the main target, not Johanna. Nazebo was who I was focused on, and I actually almost killed him. But Illidan was all over me, and the rest of our team were going after Johanna for some odd reason. So it's I can't even call that a little mistake. That's a pretty big mistake. But again, newer players are going to be expecting stuff like that. You definitely don't ever want to be focusing Johanna. There is no worse target in the game than Johanna to focus ever. So Johanna is just going to use Iron Skin just to get away. There we go. I'm going to go for Blood for Blood. Even though it was nerfed, it still does a pretty good job with executing my targets. And really, Leoric, really? Should be able to vault away here, and Shen should be able to take down Leoric. Nice job with the slowing kick there by Shen. And yeah, there we go. Hungering Arrow was just enough to take down Leoric's body right before he was able to use Wraithwalk. I gotta get away from Illidan. Unfortunately, I have to go back now. But Leoric got a little bit too overzealous. There's an Entomb on Johanna, which she will be just fine at. Not expecting Johanna to die here. Oh, unless Chen gets the body block. That flying kick body block. Nice job by Uncle Chen. And the back and forth continues in the mid lane. The Orc is already back up. Nazebo's going to die with 20 million gems on him. I did use Searing Attacks here. And our Zagara ends up saving Leoric. Try not to get hit by by Sergeant Hammer's Napalm Strike. I was able to take her out, though, thanks to Manticore. But Zagara saved Leoric there. And I'm going to turn in these 25 gems while I can. So our team was able to almost catch back up. Chen dying next to the fort definitely did not help things. That zombie wall. So if I get a chance to go after Nazebo with Reign of Vengeance, I will take it. And again, you see the damage potential of Vala with this right-click build. All you have to do is basically make sure you're staying out of danger. And you can do massive amounts of damage without really that much effort. Not going to happen this time, Joanna. Johanna's going in for the Falling Sword. And I am going to get out of Condemn. And I'm out of here. Johanna wants me bad, man. She wants me really bad. Both Nazebo's going Gargantuan, definitely a little bit suspicious, as I definitely do not consider the Gargantuan to be the better of the two. Even after the Ravenous Spirit was nerfed, I still feel that the Ravenous Spirit's the better of the two heroics. Just my opinion. I have played Nazebo for quite some time, not saying that I'm an expert or anything on it, I have played him kind of a long time. Nazebo's still my favorite specialist, I've got to say. Even after the nerfs. I wasn't there in time. I knew he was turning him in, too. Which is surprising because we had Leoric and Nazebo right there. And Vala decided to stop moving for no reason, so that was pretty cool. So, Chen's gonna get destroyed by Illidan and Nazebo. The enemy team's Leoric is... I'm not going to take any damage. I'm not sure what Chen was trying to do there. Our Nazebo definitely kind of jumped ship a little too early there. We would have needed him. We did need him for that team fight. Right now, it's 18 to 12. Surprisingly, our Nazebo is number one on hero damage. Sergeant Hammer is trying to clean up the night camp that we got earlier. And the enemy team is in prime position to take down the boss camp. So, Zagara and Nazebo are taking down the bot lane. Leoric is going to, I guess, go check to see if they are taking down the Skull Golem, which they should be. And they are not, actually. Nazebo actually just used his Gargantuan to tank it. So, if Leoric and I can take down Nazebo, we could probably steal the boss camp, and that's going to be pretty big. And we are able to take him down, so Nazebo goes down. I'm going to use Searing Attacks here on the Skull Golem, and if Leoric and I can actually get this... Oh, the enemy team's coming. Going to mount up here. And unfortunately, well, Leoric should be able to get... Should be able to escape. I should be able to escape, too. I need to see where Illidan was going. That's not going to happen, Leoric. Not going to happen there, buddy. Then use Blood for Blood to heal me. I am going to use Reign of Vengeance inside of the Entomb. I almost killed Illidan outright. I've got to go tap the fountain real quick. And we proc'd Indestructible off of Johanna. Oh, that range on Sergeant Hammer is quite redonk. Quite redonkulous. Illidan and Johanna both had to go back because they were just so close to being dead. I'm going to take Nexus Frenzy, as we are going to have a basic attack build. And now is when we really need to start pouring on the pressure in these lanes, for these team fights especially. Illidan's going to get, slowed down a little bit by our team. Actually, they are going to be able to kill him. Nice job, team. And we did not lose any keeps. The enemy team still has two forts and all three of their keeps, though. So this next Webweaver push needs to be massive for our team. I'm going to go up to the top lane and deal with the creep up there as well. Enemy team is down by two. We're down by one as far as our power play is concerned. Yeah, going for the boss actually is not a bad idea. Taking down the boss with Illidan and Sergeant Hammer both being down is a good idea. There's no baiting here. They're not going to come up here when it's 4 versus 3, Nazebo. Sorry, I hate to tell you. It's not how it works. So we are going to get the Skull Golem, which is huge. Huge, 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 huge plays. And then I don't know where Nazebo was going. He sprinted right into that zombie wall. Nazebo had no idea. I don't think he was looking at the map, to be honest. And Johanna's just going to use Falling Sword to get away. I'm going to clear the Night Camp in the mid lane. Actually check that because our team is still pushing with the boss. My team needs the damage. I'm going to use Reign of Vengeance and Blood for Blood. Destroy Leoric! Sit down, Leoric. That was so much damage. Able to take down Illidan as well thanks to Manticore's proc. And we might be able to push this for the win. The enemy team hasn't even damaged really our Grave Golem at all. Yeah, just push the core. I don't see any reason not to. The enemy team only has Johanna left, and what's she going to really do? She's going to use Condemn, and that's going to be it. I'm going to take her down with Searing Attack. So what a final push. What a turnaround there. Taking the right objective at the right time. Final total 20-20. Man, oh man, what a final push that was. Fantastic game. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a great start to your Fridays, and I'll see you all in the next video. Until then, so long, everybody!